They have, I don't know how expensive their control is, but they have a generic list in Walmart. It's a barberware.
Yeah.
And they work really well.
Really?
I don't know if they'll, I mean, I've only had it like this before.
Yeah.
Do you know what the water is called?
Oh, yeah. You know the best way to test, well, it depends on what you're using it for, right? Because not everybody needs all the water.
Right.
But if anybody's doing smoothies, the test is carrots, right? If your blender, if your device can completely obliterate carrots, then it's pretty powerful and probably exactly what you need. But if you don't need that, I usually know when this is done when it gets really warm. Because you're getting really warm.
I use my dad's
computer. You do?
Yeah, with a food processor.
Yeah.
I wish I had a better mix.
Okay, so let's go through. Does everybody hand a handout one and one? Okay, this is just a fun way to go through my mac and cheese story again. Okay, here's one that's two pages instead of double sided. Who didn't get one?
That's alright.
I'll give you one later. Yeah.
the first time I cooked this, I started asking myself, what seasonings are going to give me the flavor of cheese? And the first thing that popped in my mind was nutritional yeast, not only for its nutrition component, but also the color is really the reason why I picked it. Remember, we eat with our eyes, right? Very important. So when I was making this for the first time, and this is important for any time you try something new in the kitchen, just ask yourself, what will make this look and taste like cheese or whatever it is that you're making? And that helps you to engage your intuition muscle in the kitchen.
Fourth of a cup.
Fourth of a cup. That's an excellent suggestion. What's your name, young man? Jacob? I think you may be a chef. You like to cook? Yeah, I can tell. All right, we're going to take Jacob's suggestion. Okay? How about that? I love
the taste.
Does it have a taste? It does have a taste to it. Able to do that is simply that is listening to your body, listening, and when you get exposed to a new ingredient for the first time in your life, I believe there's a reason for that. And so when I pursued that, when somebody mentioned nutritional yeast to me, and I had never touched it before, I thought, this is worth investigating. Why not? Let me just see. In fact, it's turning out to turn out to friends. Okay, so we have our cheese sauce heating up on low on the stove. And the pasta that I am cooking for today is the Andy Green quinoa pasta. It's gluten and corn-free. Does that take care of all of the allergies? No allergies left after that, right? And I've been cooked. The ingredients are organic rice flour and organic quinoa flour. And one of the reasons I like it is because it also gets the protein on my journey right now to veganish still. Right? I have to get protein everywhere I go. And in my pasta, if it's in my pasta, I think that it helps to revive an old comfort classic. Because I think pasta's gotten a bad rap.